people have a destruction waiting on you, man. Just sitting back waiting, man. The Most High got a specific angel waiting in judgment waiting on your ass, man. So y'all going about your daily life thinking you getting away with all the wickedness you committed, not knowing the Most High got your number, man. And he don't make no fuck-ups, man. When he put out an order, it get executed, man. Go ahead, I...
Say not, I have sinned, and what harm had happened unto me?
Yep, going right back to Ecclesiastes 8 and 11, man. They think they got clean away with all the bullshit they do in this society, man, because they under the vibration of Esau, man. Thinking that everything, there's no wrong in Babylon, man. And if you do wrong according to Esau's laws, once you get in the courtroom, it's all about who pockets fatter, man. Yeah. Who can prevent the most evidence, man?
It's a racket.
Yep.
It's really who can talk the best. Cut. Who can talk the most shit? Esau's legal terminology shit.
Semantics.
Because they can tamper with evidence and corrupt evidence, you know?
Yeah. They can buy out a judge, buy out a jury, intimidate the jury. Go ahead, bro.
For the Lord is long-suffering.
Yep.
He will in no wise let thee go.
Y'all gonna get y'all judgment, man. Like you got all these cats and shit. Now that the black consciousness side netta came fucking around with Israel, now that he gravitated all type of jakes around the truth, and they talking shit, man. They talking about, oh, when is this black man coming to crack the skies open? When is all these prophecies about to be fulfilled? When is this gonna happen? When that gonna happen? When the Most High got it set to happen, that's the only answer we can give you. We don't know the exact time and hour, but we know it's damn close to it. You got all type of shit popping off, man. You got war back brewing in Yemen, all over in that area, man. Russia's fucking steady sending threats to America that y'all better chill the fuck out, or we going getting ready to take action, man. You got China and Russia just got ready to do the largest joint military exercise in the Navy, man, with all different on the coast over there, close to China and Russia. They about to do a major joint military exercise. And who you think they prepping to go to war with, man? America, man. So y'all can ask all these silly questions, ask for documentation, scientific equations, but guess what? Faith and spirituality is the only thing that's going to give you understanding of what's coming, man. Go ahead.
Concerning propitiation, be not without fear to add sin unto sin.
Yep, and that's what Jake is doing, man. Jake don't have no fear of the Heavenly Father, so he's adding sin on the sin, man. They're like the brother was saying, they're getting worse and worse and worse, man. I keep saying it, but I just keep picturing how bugged out and crazy it is on a high school campus now, man. With the way these niggas is dressing, all the freaky homosexual acts, man. And you see it, man, it's gonna come a split in the educational system, man, because I was talking to my 13-year-old niece, man, and the shit they teaching now is just asinine, man. And you got a lot of these teachers who starting to buck up. I ain't gonna say a lot, but it's a small number of teachers who don't want to teach that bullshit that's in the curriculum, man. Because they seeing what it could do, man. They ain't saying that's a large number, but it's a lot of people bucking up against this bullshit educational system, man. Because they see where it's leading, man. They seeing the high rate of homosexuality in a fucking middle school, man. They had that gas that Clip the Apostle's Heart did. You had that Jake Faggot got kicked out of school for wearing high heels and a skirt to school, man, with a fucking wig on, man. And you niggas want this place to go on, man. You want your kids to grow up around that shit? Yeah, but man, Jake is adding sin on the sin, man. Why? Because they have no fear. We brought out in Jeremiah earlier, they know not their God and they know not the judgment of the Heavenly Father, man. Thus, they continue on in wicked ways because they have liberty to do so under the power of Esau, man.
And say not, his mercy is great, He will be pacified for the multitude of my sins.
Yep, the Most High will be pacified for the multitude of your sins, man. What do you do with a pacifier? You put a pacifier in a baby mouth to calm them down, man. You're not going to calm the Most High down. First of all, the Most High, you can't comprehend the Most High in his mind, man. It's not something you can give a definition to or a category. It just is. And it's not to be questioned or fucked with. Oh, yeah?
For mercy and wrath come from him, and his indignation rested upon sinners.
Yep, it rested upon sinners. It says sinners. His righteous anger rested upon the sinners, man. So you're not going to get away with your little hearted out quotes for longer, man. Oh, the Lord hate the sin, but not the sinner.
Right.
Well, okay. Now, according to your logic, if the Most High did hate sin, why the fuck would you continue on doing something that the Most High hates, man? That shows you the hypocrisy and the love for wickedness that you jakes have, man.
Hey, what they say is God knows my heart. You know what I'm saying? They'll be getting ready to do wickedness, but they'll be like, you know what? God knows my heart, so it, you know,
true.
It don't matter.
You know your heart is wicked, man. It's deceitfully wicked.
Yeah, when it's talk about the pacifier part, read that again, brother. I'll get right back to you.
Okay. And say not, his mercy is great. He will be pacified for the multitude of my sins.
Meaning if the Most High is angry, because the Most High is pissed off, angry as hell for the multitude of Israel's sins, pacify basically means to bring, to restore. This is just a loose definition, basically. If someone's angry, in this case, we're talking about the Most High, he's pissed off and angry behind wickedness. You pacify somebody, you take that angry state and calm it down.
Sorry.
You know? Or bring peace, or bring them to a state of peace.
Yeah.
And that's not going to happen.
Verse 7. Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord, and put not off from day to day.
Yeah, when if you part of the elect of the 144,000, man, you're going to adhere to this word, man. You're going to get down with this work, man. But to these others, man, they making a tarrying to getting with the Most High. And Jake said, this ain't my time, man. I'm trying, I got all these other things, man. And then what's that parable in Matthew, man, when it was going into one man had oxen to tend to, one man that just got married. Jacob come up with all the excuses possible to not do this work, man.
Hey, get that thing on, bro. 3-1 to go right with this, man. Read that again,
verse 7. Okay, verse 7. Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord, and put not off from day to day. For suddenly shall the wrath of the Lord come forth, and in thy security thou shalt be destroyed,
yep,
and perish in the day of vengeance.
Yep, make no tarrying, man, mean shit, man, be about this truth, man. Come back to the Most High, because you don't know when he's gonna, when Yahweh shot, basically you don't know when Yahweh's gonna send Yahweh shot back to destroy this place. It could be any time, man. And you don't want to get caught slipping, man, and have the Lord come up on you like a thief in the night.
Right.
So what that say, brother?
3-1?
Yeah.
Woe, Nahum 3-1. Woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery. The prey departed not.
Yeah, the prey departed not, which the prey are you 2/3 Israelites, man. 1/3 either woke up or will wake up, you know, basically. Some of them ain't gonna even wake up till Yahweh Shah come back. But basically, the prey are you Jakes, Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. So how do you depart? You depart like the scriptures say, by coming back to the Most High. That's why the scriptures say make no tarrying, because every day you stay locked into Babylon, into that vibration, this white man is preying on you, man. This white man, like they got the 10-year anniversary of Katrina. You know what I'm
know, these niggas, man, basically, well, you had testimony of Jake saying they heard explosions. Well, they basically blew up the levees and flooded out of Louisiana. Jake's still trying to go back in there, but what they did was a gentrification.
Right.
It was a gentrification, man. Man, they closed down them projects. Man, fucking tore that shit down. They building up condos and skyscrapers and shit. And then they asked this one woman on the news, yeah, is this not the same New Orleans? She said, no, it ain't the same. Because Jake out of there, man. Jake have a vibration that only Jake makes shit lively, man. Even though them niggas was wicked.
And those joints would be popping. Most of them are closed up now. The people aren't here anymore. They didn't come back. I would love to be able to buy a piece of property in this neighborhood and have my kids grow up the way I did. It's above my pay grade.
The neighborhood is a different neighborhood now. It's not the real Sixth Ward no more. All these people coming buying all the property up. It changes like almost a gated community. And they don't want this culture to keep going.
Like a tourist field instead of a family field. You know, and I'm saying that to say this, man. This white man is constantly, man, using you niggas, getting over on you niggas, man. Destroying, showing you niggas that he don't love. Under that cloak that this white man is righteous. Under the cloak that this white man means you good. When we come out here, man, we prophesy telling you that this white man, the so-called white man, is the devil. Y'all don't want to receive it. Y'all don't want to believe it. After everything he's showing you, man. Katrina. Going back to Black Wall Street. Tulsa, Oklahoma. After that, if you niggas will pick up a book
George
and
Bush
read,
doesn't
man,
care about
like
black
you
people.
Read the Book of Maccabees, it's just one account after the other of the white man going back on contracts that he made with Jakes. Just incident after incident of this devil just basically, his word ain't worth shit. His word ain't worth shit. And you can trace that all the way back to fucking Cain and Abel.
His contracts ain't shit. His
right. Right, his contracts, you know, his word. You cannot trust this fucking white man. But y'all want to remain under this Babylonian vibration, man, where this white man got you deceived, man. White Jesus did a number on you niggas, man. Chester A. Boys here, man, done you niggas in. Anytime something happened, you go pray to Caesar Boys here. And so the white man put more hell on you with the white man. When y'all gonna learn and wake up to who you are as a people, as a nation? You Negroes, Latinos, you Native Americans are the Israelites that the scriptures speak of.
That's right.
And until y'all come out of that, that's why I read that one more time, until you come out of that trance, the white man gonna continue to put foot on your ass, man.
Woe to the bloody city. It is full of lies and robbery.
The bloody city is right here in America, man. What they did out there in Katrina 10 years ago, man, that was bloody. And then you had Edomites who were just having target practice on niggas that were looking for help. You, Jake, were just looking for help, man. Y'all was hungry, thirsty, destitute. And them crackers wasn't letting you come through their neighborhoods, man, to go get help. They opened fire on you niggas, man. Your buddy, the white man. The so-called white man, who the scriptures call the nation of Edom. They were picking y'all off. And here it is, like earlier today, man, we was out here and we cut this devil with the scripture, and then he go across the street, you got Jake over there trying to calm his soul. Yeah,
pacify him.
Right, he was pacifying him. Yeah. You know, we could just tell in the spirit what was happening. We didn't have to hear the conversation. But you could tell, man, some Uncle Tom ass nigga over there kissing his white man's ass. when the white man just said, fuck the Bible. Let's show you Jakes have contempt for Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, and you love this fucking white man. That's why two-thirds of you, when the brother read Zechariah 13, man, that's, I can't wait till this white, to Most High use this white man to start killing you. That's what you call poetic justice. When the same devil that you love so much turn and rend your ass. That's poetic justice. Man, we're gonna laugh. We're gonna, if we got some wine to pour up on that day, man, we're gonna toast and pour up. We're gonna celebrate to the destruction of you two-third niggas, man. And he kept asking about the brother's earrings, man.
Yeah.
We're like, hey, man, we don't have no, fuck them goddamn Hamites, man.
Those real diamonds? You support slavery in Africa?
Yeah, I knew that was what, exactly what he was gonna say. You know, that's the Uncle Tom nigga right there. Look how he walked right
there. Yeah, that nigga should have came up here. Huh? Checked on him and said, damn, what's going on, bro?
Like
I was talking about earlier, we hated by everybody, so you got these idiots, niggas, fools downtown,
so whenever they see a white person walk away from here, a so-called white person, they go to comfort them. Hey, man, don't worry about those guys, man, they're crazy. We don't all think like that. They'll do anything to be friends with the fucking white man.
Yeah, and this white man, according to that's Sirach the 12th chapter, He let you get close to him so he can put that knife in your back.
Yeah, that's right.
He'll play that perfect role, act like your buddy, man, and the whole time he plotting how to get over on you, man. Y'all still don't see it. He's showing you every day, y'all still don't see it, man.
That's the point of these contracts. These contracts, they are designed to fuck you over, man.
Yeah.
There's no good contracts with the devil, man. He show you that in his movies, man. Like that movie series, The Wishmaster, man. He'll grant you a wish, but along with that wish came some fucked up destruction on your ass, man.
You know how Esau fucks the American people, but the ones that get it the worst is, you know, of course, the Israelites. They'll have something written in the contract, and then they'll create a chaos, for lack of a better word. Or they'll create a situation to where they can have to write some more writings to supersede what their prior writings or their prior contract. Perfect example is the Constitution. The Constitution is laid out, and they got, man, I don't know how many executive orders that override, supersedes the Constitution.
Yeah. Anytime or in case of emergency, which is basically left up to the discretion of the president.
But they created them, them false flag terrorist attacks, and they created chaos so they can come in with more regulations, more executive orders.
So yeah, man, look at that scripture again, man. The bloody city is America, man. All you niggas, look at all these cops, man, shooting Jake down in the street, man, putting you niggas in chokeholds, man, choking you out. Body slamming you to this concrete on this pavement, man. Slamming your heads, your skulls into the ground, man. Bitches getting killed in these jailhouses and prisons.
Yeah. Putting their knees in your back. Putting knees in your fucking back.
Committing quote-unquote suicide. You know, this is a bloody city, man, to you Israelites. You know, go ahead.
Woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery.
It is all full of lies and robbery, man. Like the brother say, you can't trust this white man contract. The proof of that is fine print. Why you gonna have the whole contract written in one font, and then you get down to the end of the contract, it's fine print?
Yeah,
that should let you know that's something, he up to something slick. Yeah, brother.
Ain't it something where you gotta actually get a microscope to read the print?
Yeah, you do for some of this shit, man.
Yeah, hey, you know in them commercials when they trying to sell you a car, they're advertising these new cars that come out, and they say you can get it at 0% APR and such down payment, and then when they get to, at the end of that commercial, they start speaking fast, they telling you it's only for qualified, basically you gotta have good credit to get that.
That's right. Because you're dealing with the devil. And then the white man, he was so, he got so frustrated with the word, he went on and admitted he was the devil, man. And he said to hell with that Bible. That's what we're trying to show you, man. Okay. You're the devil. But go ahead, it's full of lies and robbery. All this white man do is lie. Ain't that right, sir? All the white man ever does is lie. Your whole existence is a fucking lie.
Yep.
That's all y'all do. That's all y'all know, man. Y'all are the devil. Meaning deceivers of the earth.
Fact.
Now, you know, like he can't hear, man. Yeah, he that's a goddamn that's lie right lie. There. You know you hear me talking to you, you fucking devil. That's all they know. Is they can't do nothing else. The scripture tell you, go to, give me John 8. No, yeah. We're going to go down to 5. Yeah.
The prey departed not.
Right, the prey are you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Y'all departed not because y'all refused to return to Yahweh Ba'asham, Yahweh Shah. Y'all want to stay locked into this wicked vibration and continue your wickedness. Eating your pork, eating your shrimp, your lobster, all your shellfish, man. Crawfish etouffee. All that madness. Y'all want to keep doing that. Y'all want to keep going to church praying to white Jesus. Make everything okay. But these wicked niggas in these, behind these pulpits tell you, yeah, just sow a seed. That's all you need, man. Just put that seed in the plate, and then the Most High, you're going to go home today, and you're going to get that call Monday morning, and it's going to be a new job. And they tell you shit like that.
Hey, y'all, they go as far as they'll tell you to go check your bank account. You're going to have $20,000 deposit.
Yeah, they'll tell you how much money you're going to have.
Or a check come in the mail.
That mug, right. that dollar amount ain't on your bank account. Then they say you didn't sow enough.
Yeah.
Your heart wasn't right when you gave that
it's
seed.
Your fault.
Hey, you had
your heart wasn't right. Yeah.
The infomercials for Edith Mike selling, Edith Mike pastor.
That's it.
Was selling
prayer. Hell yeah, we're going with that.
See, Esau, man. Esau. Well, this is what you niggas want to love, man.
Yeah. But you had this damn Edomite pastor with a church nothing full of jakes, man, selling prayer oil and shit. And this black woman giving him
Google Maps right there.
About, I took that prayer oil and I rubbed it all on my son's shoes, all over his doorway in his room. And Monday morning, he had a job waiting on him.
See? Right.
Then she said, she didn't say thank the Most High. She said, I want to thank him. Little Edomite pastor said, dog, thank him for this prayer oil.
And who was that? Herod got killed for that shit in the book of Acts. I believe that was Herod, one of the, I forget which Herod, but he something happened, and then they say, oh, it's a god. And he didn't give the Most High the credit for whatever happened. The Most High made you right. You see, that's what's going to happen to a lot of these pastors, man. Their congregation is going to turn on them for teaching lies. But that goes back to Nahum, the third chapter. This whole land is full of lies and robbery, man. First of all, y'all took this land from Gad and Issachar and Reuben. Then you go down Central and South America, man, y'all took that all from the Latin tribes, man. Now, after Zebulun, that's what I'm trying to think of. Zebulun, Asher, Naphtali, Simeon, all y'all just robbed, man. Y'all robbed and steal and murder. Manasseh over there in Cuba, they still in that land, but they being oppressed in their own land, or the land that they founded. Being oppressed in their own land. Hey, you know America's gonna be destroyed, right? Come here, talk to me for a minute. You got a minute? Yeah, okay. See, the white man, they know they wicked. They know that all the atrocities is catching up with them. They know their time is up. Now she acting like she got so much to do. She ain't got nothing to do. She ain't got nothing to do. She just going somewhere to be wicked. Because that's all they know how to do is be wicked. Now judgment is upon these devils, man. Judgment is upon y'all. And y'all can't face the music. You're walking like you got something to do. Bitch, you ain't got shit to do, brother. Read the scripture. She's a little thick, but she's still getting judged.
Hey, can I say something before you finish in that scripture? Yeah. A lot of them Latin, well, the Latin tribes are being oppressed because Esau got all these regulations in place, governmental regulations and whatnot. I don't want to say that, but not shit.
Yeah, being oppressed in their own land, man. I mean, it's war zones. When you go into them Latin countries from Mexico all the way down to Chile, man, it's war zones, man. Yeah. And behind these drugs, man, the white man is the goddamn devil, man.
Hey, because they drunk in their philosophy, because Esau pushed that wine.
Because in Brazil, they got the big white Jesus on the statue.